Well, we've had some hopeful developments in agriculture. Recently, 2018 was still a tough year for many farmers in Louisiana. Some have elected not to return to farming next year. It was so tough.
TWILA's Neil Malasson brings us the story of one rice farmer who won't be returning to the fields this year and worries there'll be more like him.
When Hurricane Harvey dumped rain across southwest Louisiana, rice farmer Kevin Birkin had his lands inundated. It wasn't just the rain that had him worried. It was the years of bad prices and unfavorable weather.
This is the third year in a row of below average rice yields, third year in a row of being difficult for us in the rice industry.
2 years later, these are Kevin Birkin's empty fields. He's out of farming completely, and in addition to his rice, the 300 acres of beans he had went underwater as well, like most farms in Jeff Davis Parish back in September.
And I've got neighbors who are stalwarts of third, fourth, fifth generation farmers that are no longer going to farm simply because there's no money in it. I've actually had one neighbor tell me that, well, I'm not making any money, but I'm not losing a whole bunch. And I got to thinking, that's not the way where it's supposed to be.
It's a situation Kyle McCann says isn't working well for rice farmers as a whole.
Currently, rice prices are still marginal at best. With our high cost of production and the returns that they're getting from the marketplace, it's not sufficient in and of itself to keep a lot of rice farms in business.
Those dire economics were certainly a topic at the American Farm Bureau Convention. Louisiana President Ronnie Anderson says with a government shutdown still in effect, we may lose farmers who can't get funding for the next crop.
We're losing rice farmers, we're losing bean farmers, and if this USDA thing with the government closed, I'm not sure how financing is going to work over the next month to 6 weeks if things don't open up pretty fast.
Back in Jeff Davis Parish, there are signs of hope. Kevin has plans to bring his farming experience to the Capitol in Baton Rouge as a state senator, with the plight of the farmer at the top of his agenda. He's met with a farmer who's agreed to farm the land here, so it will be in production for next year and hopefully for years to come. For This Week in Louisiana Agriculture, I'm Neil Malasson.
Kevin Birkin made the official announcement on January 24th that he is going to run for the state Senate seat for Southwest Louisiana, and obviously with the possibility of the farmers getting out of the business, we're going to continue to follow this story.
Absolutely.